Now what we want to do is add a dynamic URL to the individual pumps, and we can do that by using the URI data reference within PyAF. We're going to add this data reference as an attribute to our pump template, so we can just go ahead and browse to our pump template or whatever template you're working with. You can still add an attribute that'll point to a display of your choosing by going through this procedure. Now, building this is pretty simple. We're just going to go ahead and build out a new attribute template, and we'll see if we give it the name of attribute one. I'm going to call this asset health dashboard, basically just telling us, yes, this is the URL to that dashboard that we created before. And under the data reference type, we're going to choose URI builder. And at this point, we're able to go into the settings of this, and we can start basically creating this. So what we want to do here is we want to select our PyVision here, and we need to give it three things. We need to give it the PyVision website address. We need to give it the portion of that address for the display itself. And then we're also going to create a parameter here. We'll see that here in a second, that will set the focus of the display. So you'll recall when we were going through it and using the dashboard, we can actually swap between the pumps. So what we really want is to be able to open up this display and have it set that asset context to the pump that generated the notification. So our PyVision address, I've already copied a lot of this out. Our PyVision URL is right here. That'll be the URL of your PyVision server. We'll go ahead and copy and paste that into this portion here. The display is just going to be that display portion of the URL, and I've already included that here as well. And then the parameter that we're going to add is for the, where we want this to be for the asset itself. And the value is, we could pick a lot of the other attribute values that exist here, and related attribute values, substitution parameters is really where we want to be here. We want to use a couple of those things. So I've already included those in this as well. So this is basically what we want to do. We want it to be the system that we're set to. So this is the PyAF database that we're currently connected to. In the database of in question, the one that we're using, which is, that's what this substitution parameter says. And then it's going to give us the full element path. So if we just copy and paste this here, this should actually work. This should tell us this is actually what we're going to be focused on. And if we click OK here, that's going to expand out this. That's basically going to create the URL for us that we can then go back and use in the completion of our Py notification configuration. Now, before we move on to that notification portion, we want to make sure we check in our changes. That's always good practice. Just check those things in whenever we reach a good stopping point, someplace where we could potentially stop our work and pick up later on. So we'll go ahead and check in those changes, and then we'll go ahead and click over into our notification rule template again and look at those formats, manage those formats for that high bearing temperature notification that we had been working on before. We'll go ahead and select global default email, and we'll duplicate this selected format. That'll give us this copy here, which we can go ahead and change. We're just going to call this whatever we want, but I'll go ahead and call this pump bearing temperature. And at this point, we can go ahead and start customizing some of that content, right? So we have all the content that we had reviewed before, but if we go into our element attribute properties, we should now see that we have an entry here for the asset health dashboard. And what we want to include here is that hyperlink. So we can go ahead and drag and drop this onto the display, and then I'll actually put this asset health dashboard hyperlink down at the bottom. We can go ahead and look at our HTML preview at this point, and that HTML preview should show a hyperlink to the asset health dashboard. So now not only have we included all of this information here, we've also included that asset health dashboard. If we clicked on it after a notification's created, then we will be able to go directly to that maintenance dashboard and start troubleshooting our pump asset. So we're going to go ahead and click OK here. So that'll save out that pump bearing temperature. Again, we check that in just to make sure we commit those changes. And at this point, we want to edit our subscriptions. We'll go ahead and look at those subscriptions. We see we don't have anything here yet. We can go ahead and just click on some pump groups. We have a pump maintenance group here. We could also include some escalation teams. So if we wanted to, we could send it to team A, and then if no one acknowledges, send it to team B, and so on and so forth until we get an acknowledgement or several acknowledgements. One other thing to point out here is we have multiple different types of delivery endpoints. So we have emails, that's definitely something that we can work with. But you can also create delivery endpoints to web services. So not only could we send a notification to a maintenance worker or just somebody who needs to know about the health of this asset, we could also potentially start the planned maintenance process by sending some information via web services, delivering that to a web services endpoint for the maintenance management system or something that can send that data off or broker that connection to the maintenance management system. So not only are you notifying people, you're also notifying systems. So in this case, I'm just going to use one of those groups that have already been created, drag and drop that over here onto the display, onto the subscriptions window, and click OK. Now again, at this point, we want to make sure that all of our changes are checked in. We'll go ahead and check those things in. And now we should, the next time this high bearing temperature notification kicks off, we'll get a message in our inbox that'll include that content that we configured.